the year Hollywood had, you know, with Weinstein and Spacey et al., you'd kind of think that its brightest stars would practice some humility on the whole moral barometer front. Well, no such luck. Instead, one of America's favorite actors is insulting the president just to sell his movie. The swipe comes from actor Tom Hanks, who's given us so many iconic moments on the screen, the big screen, but he kind of flops as a political commentator and pundit. Hanks informed The Hollywood Reporter that he doesn't think he would screen his new film called The Post at the White House if he was asked. Why not? Imagine a world, Hanks explained, where a president treats papers like The Washington Post as purveyors of fake news. Hey, Gump, maybe he treats them that way because half the time they are. The actor stars in Steven Spielberg's new flick, The Post, about the paper's decision in the 70s to publish the top secret details about the Vietnam War in the Pentagon Papers. The difference is Ben Bradley, the editor of The Washington Post at the time, actually had the Pentagon Papers. Today, The Post routinely uses anonymous sources in all of its reporting, and most of it, at least when it's damning against Trump, and all too often gets things totally wrong that they then have to backtrack on or modify. Oh, by the way, and Tom Hanks needn't worry. As Daily Variety pointed out, President Trump has not asked to screen the film The Post at the White House, so no worries. Maybe it's time to, I don't know, cast away Tom Hanks. I kind of liked him better, by the way, on the deserted island, talking to that volleyball. That was cute. That's the dialogue that I enjoy from Tom Hanks. Riveting. I almost thought it was a basketball I'd forgotten.